My name is Michael Hatch, and I am a teacher here at Prosper High School. I teach audio video production. I'm over an advisor for Eagle Nation News and for PHS The Talent Radio. So when I was in high school, in fact, exactly your age, I was sitting in a class and my teacher, what I heard, I think they heard me do a presentation, and they said, Hatch, you know something? You should think about doing the announcements. I was like, okay, I'll do the announcements. So I went and I talked to the principal, and I did that through a couple of years of high school with a couple of friends of mine. And it was through that another teacher said, you know something, like, you should go get into radio. Have you thought about that? I was like, yeah, I kind of have. Because when I was a kid, I used to love to listen to the radio and record the DJs, either from a little tape recorder going up and putting it in front of the speaker, or just as much as getting a stereo for Christmas one year and putting cassettes in and recording the DJs and recording the songs. That is how I got into it as well. So it all started for me in college radio. I worked for a radio station called 92 Rock, and it was WWLR in Lindenville, Vermont. And that was a college station. So I started off being on the air there, and then I moved up to being a music director for about a year. And then for my last years, my junior and my senior year, I was the general manager of the radio station. Going back to college radio, one of the things that we used to love to do is, because college radio is kind of freeform. We had like rock during the day, but then we had specialized shows throughout the evening. So I was just as much into rock as I was into like rap and hip hop. And I was like the rap and hip hop director on top of being the music director. So like folks like Snoop Dogg and Dr. Dre and like even Kid Rock, I had an interview with Kid Rock, you know, just artists like that. It was cool to be able to say that you helped break them. And there was a documentary recently that Dr. Dre did with Jimmy Iovine, that it was on HBO, and he thanked everybody that helped get his music out there in college radio. I was like, that was me. So, I mean, that was really cool. We had specialized shows that we would do that we would really promote. We put like posters all over the campus and everything. And one big one that we did every year was the disco show. And we all think like disco sucks, and it does kind of suck, but there's something to be said of it. There's a little bit of charm to it. So one of the things that we did for kind of a promotional thing is we went on the air, and back in the 70s when disco was big, was streaking. We didn't streak. We didn't like get naked because it was a cold Vermont winter. We don't want to be like doing that. But we got down to our boxer shorts and we delivered pizza to all of the dorms in our boxer shorts. We basically streaked and delivered pizza. And I don't think there was a lot of video back then, so I don't think there's video of that, which is good because we don't want that. After there, I worked at a bunch of other radio stations around New Hampshire. 95.7 WZID, I did promotions on there and kind of behind the scenes. Worked at another station, 96.5 The Fox. I was the music director on the air. 98.3 WLNH. So that was a pop station, rock station. And then finally moved down here to Dallas, and I worked for CBS Radio, which turned into Intercom, which turned into Odyssey and a bunch of different names. For that station, or those stations, I worked for 100.3 Jack FM, and then I worked for 103.7 KVIL, and that had several different names to it too. When I got here to Texas, the long story short, before, you know, I started working and, you know, teaching here in Texas and then just generally in radio in Dallas, there was a job that came up for American Broadcasting School, which has since closed, but they were looking for a job placement director. And I was like, okay, this is kind of a cool way for me to get back into radio a little bit and broadcasting, because I could start there. But I made it very clear when I was being interviewed, I said, well, I have industry experience and I'd love to be able to teach. So maybe after a year or two, they let me do some teaching and I would listen to radio shows and critique them and things like that. The other thing that I've really loved throughout the years is just being on the air. It's so much fun to be on the air. And there are so many times that you're gonna walk into doing your radio show. You're on the air, you'll take some calls from listeners and things like that, but you won't necessarily immediately see that people listen to you. So I've always enjoyed going out to remote broadcasts because listeners will come out to meet just you. And it sort of revitalizes you, it sort of re-energizes you, because there's so many times you just get on, you get on the air, you have so much fun and you put yourself out there, but there's not a lot that comes back to you. But when you go out to a remote, people will recognize you, they'll be like, oh yeah, you're so-and-so. That's always been fun. And the other thing that I've really liked too, especially here in Dallas, I was really, really lucky, even though I was part-time, to meet a lot of artists and see a lot of real up-close and intimate performances from these artists. There's a showroom that they have right now at Odyssey that's, I don't remember what they show it right now or what they call it right now, but they have performers that come in that it's like 50 to maybe 100 that you could fit into this small stage area. So I saw and met Blondie, Charlie Puth. So just artists like that, that they would play, and right where you're sitting is where they would be, and you could stand that close, and like Charlie Puth is there on his keyboard, just like he's playing it for you.